This is Michael Hinojosa with a special shout out to the Lincoln Tigers class of 2021. We're inviting all seniors to return to campus April 12th to end the school year strong. At Lincoln, I hear if seniors come back in really strong numbers, there's a good chance for a graduation ceremony and a prom. So seniors, come back on April 12th to claim your senior privileges.
Go to school, it's the bomb. This is an adopted excerpt from The Accommodation. The first explosion came in early February 1950 at night. It was at the home of Horace Ballmer. He had bought a house just a few blocks outside of a black neighborhood near X-Line Park. A car slipped up in front of the house, an arm reached out through a roll-down window and tossed out an expertly made bomb of dynamite in gelatin form. It was the type they commonly used in the oil field. The bomb looped lazily from the street, spinning slowly through the air and flopping down next to the house. By August, five more black-owned houses had been bombed. No one had been killed or injured, but that was only due to random good luck and a good God. The terror among black families that had been ventured on the white turf had become thick and tangible, like an illness, but they kept on buying houses. 40 extra police officers were assigned to the small area where most of the bombings were taking place. They were patrolling each house every 5 minutes. The bombings not only continued, but grew bolder. As the grand jury was about to meet, Henry Wade, the district attorney, said, and I quote, "I do not feel like the grand jury cares to waste time with instigators of race, trouble, and communist sympathizers who know nothing about the facts in this case," unquote. You can live and go to school in South Dallas, also known as Bombingham. That says that you've been left a legacy. You are the descendants of people who defied all odds to be here. You have a right to an education, but more importantly, you have a responsibility. Six black homes were bombed in 6 months. They didn't want you to live here or go to school here. I'm not asking that you return to the campus. I'm asking you to honor the families who believed in you even before you were born. South Dallas story is a story of oppressed people who overcome every obstacle and became free men and women. Even before this international pandemic, people of color have suffered an epidemic in this country. COVID-19 has a vaccine, but racism is spreading again and there's no cure. The only people that can make racism less lethal is an education. You need to go to school. The only vaccine you may ever get is waiting in the halls of academia of Lincoln High School.